So we have a drill that we call the flow drill at our school, and it helps with all of the hand positioning for the Kihon Hapo Torte Goho Gata methods. Mote Gyaku, Ur Gyaku, Onikadaki, Mushodori, and Gunseki Nage. And there's different hand positions where your fingers and hands need to be in the exact right places to help lock joints and wrists and shoulders and everything else up. So we've designed this flow drill for this. We'll do the basic version first, and then we go into advanced versions where there's a hit in between, or we close our eyes and we're blindfolded and things like that. So we'll just get right into it. So the flow drill starts with one person holding out their hands. The other person starts to grab and does a Mote Gyaku, goes right into Ur Gyaku, goes into Onikadaki, then into Mushodori, and comes around into Gunseki Nage. Mote Gyaku, Ur Gyaku, Onikadaki, Mushodori, Gunseki Nage. Another person does it. So what this is doing is it's causing repetition for the student to have their hands and their body starting to move in the exact right positions for these locks to be put on. It's not meant to be a practical application scenario of here's what I'm going to do, because nobody's just going to hold out their hand and let you take it in real life. They're going to be coming in and doing something else. But for getting this down, it's a great thing. Getting your hand positions correct, starting to learn how to use your body this time. He's taking more advanced steps. Every time he's moving, now he's putting a movement with his footwork in this time, instead of just using his hands. So that's just taking it up a notch. So this flow drill, you should be trying and practicing at your dojo, and with your friends, brothers, sisters, moms, dads, whatever makes you happy. All get to share the Bujinkan love all over the planet with the flow drill. The next version, we put a hit in between each one. So as he does a Mote Gyaku, he gives a hit somewhere with his foot, with his hand, with his body, headbutting, anything. We just try and get a touch in between so that we're starting to realize and open the student's mind up to different applications that can happen, so that we're not just trapped in one singular movement. We start to broaden our mind and know, hey, I can do things in between, so I'm not just tied into one technique in one particular way. We teach those at first that way for basics, but later on we go advanced. And that's where you want to start to bring your mind out. Awesome. So let's come closer to the camera now. And we'll do a slow version. Can the camera come up close on the hands? Okay, so Mote Gyaku. Flipping around with that hand. Notice he's never losing touch in between each one. There's always contact happening. It's like sticky hands for some other movement in other martial arts in between each one. And that's a great example. So this flow drill is one thing that you should try and expand. We do it with weapons in our hands sometimes also. We put blindfolds on, eyes closed, whatever works. You want to just go with this and feel it out and see what you can make of it. There's a lot that can be done with it, so try this one at home.
Mm-hmm.